Thank you all for tuning into this episode of Influencers Network, sitting here with Simone Smith. She has a show on MyTCN TV called Here to Help You. And she's a mental health advocate as well, which we'll get into.
Yes.
But first things first, thank you very much.
Of course.
I appreciate it.
Of course.
Yeah, so before getting into the show and mental health, please tell us about yourself.
Okay, so I go by Simone Jennifer Smith. I actually like to use all three names. Secret behind that is... Okay. You're given two names and we only use one of them most of our lives. I'm like, I'm using all three.
Right.
Funny thing I found out, and this is a little side note, is that serial killers use their three names as well.
Are you serious? So are you telling
us
right
now? Am I a
serial
killer? I don't know.
Right.
Maybe.
I guess we're going to find out.
Yeah, I guess you guys will find out, I guess. And I wouldn't even tell you who my demographic is, but
right.
Thank you very much for having me here.
On that same topic, I read somewhere that if you use your middle initial when you're signing documents or as an author of a book, it makes you seem a little more astute and professional as well.
I didn't know that. So
yeah.
I just figured Jennifer is on. And plus, it serves for my two sides of my personality too. There's the Simone side and there's the Jennifer side.
I like
very
that.
Different.
So we're going to get into that as well. That's part of the mental aspect of our conversation.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, so again, tell us about your journey up until this point.
So my journey has been... It's been an interesting one.
Mm-hmm.
And I say that because it is typical, like, I guess not so typical. I grew up with both my parents. So I had mom and dad in my home.
Yeah.
That served very well for me because it gave me a lot of balance. I'm a very balanced individual because I had both that feminine energy and that negative, not negative, that male energy. Sorry, that was not a slip. Dad, I love you. You're not negative at all.
It was an accident.
It was a complete accident. But the male energy in my life, and they're both ministers, so that also kept me very grounded.
Okay.
I have that Christian background that has allowed me to obviously make some really good decisions in my life.
Right.
And when I did make bad decisions, I kind of understood why life kind of turned out the way it had.
Right.
Because I hadn't, it has nothing to do with just following Christian beliefs. It's just a matter of living your life in balance.
Mm.
You know, we can't be always good.
Right.
But we can't be always bad.
Of course.
So I've learned to embrace, and that will go into the Simone and Jennifer. I've learned to embrace both sides of who that is. And that has allowed me to get to where I am. Like, I work very hard.
Mm.
I have my master's in humanistic and clinical psychology. That's where my love is.
Right.
It's been there since I was 16 years old.
Mm.
True story. My grandmother, I actually watched my grandmother lose her mind, which is what got me into this profession, because I told my mom, I said, Mom, if I lose my mind, I want to know when it's happening and how it's happening.
So you can be sort of self-aware, watch
absolutely
yourself from the outside.
Absolutely, right. I need to have an Innerstanding as to why things are happening to me.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's a lot of the reasons why many of us suffer with mental health illnesses is because we have no idea what's happening. It's just happening and we're just living through it.
Of course.
Right. So once I saw that, I said no. And I'm one of those young people who knew their purpose very early in her life, and I've never swayed from it. I've had other gifts, obviously, and talents. Writing is a talent for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm able to present ideas and stories in a way. Well, more ideas, I present them like stories.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about storytelling because it's a way to help people identify, especially when it comes to mental health. You have to be so careful because people are very sensitive about that topic in general, right?
Right.
So that's kind of me and who I am and what I do. And I know I'm at the very beginning of my journey.
Yeah.
I know every day. It's like, what am I going to learn today? Because I know I'm at the very beginning. Even though I'm bucking 40, I still like, I know.
Right.
You know, I know that I've learned a lot, and I'm starting a whole new chapter. Every single year, every single day, it's always something new.
Yeah. So it seems like self-awareness has been a big part of your journey so far.
My entire life.
Right.
My entire life.
There are so many people I've spoken to in the past who don't know what they want to do, don't know what their purpose is. They're kind of just going day to day, 9-to-5 job, trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
How did you know your purpose so early on? Was it just that experience?
It was that experience.
Okay.
And that's usually what it is. It's you have to go through something sometimes to understand what moves you and what calls you. It's unfortunate that many of us live our whole lives and have no idea. We die with all these unanswered dreams and mm-hmm. and thoughts and, you know, things that can be turned into action, but right. we don't do anything about them. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm thankful that I knew right away what I was supposed to do.
Right.
You know, and now I'm doing it the best way I can and dealing with a very tough topic. Mm-hmm. Right.
So do you think everyone has a purpose in life?
Yes. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Every single person is born. You are born for a reason. There is no one out here who was just born to be, or you don't just exist. We are existing.
Right.
But you're not born here just to exist. Mm-hmm. Right. I think, again, because of a lot of the social pressures, a lot of the things that we see, obviously, on the media, mm-hmm. Some of the things we're born into, you know, like our family situations, our right. communities, I think a lot of that finds a way of killing. I'm going to be very strong with that word. It does. It will kill any thoughts of purpose.
Because we're nurtured in the wrong way.
We're surviving, mm. a lot of us. We're just trying to get through that moment, that day, that paycheck, that, right. you know, that 9 to 5, that it's survival. And if you're trying to survive, you can't focus on purpose.
Right.
Who has time for that, right? I'm just trying to get to tomorrow. So
I had a talk with someone yesterday and for a different interview. We're talking about the same thing, just in terms of thoughts that I've had, more on a philosophical note about we have one life to live, and at the end of it, that's it. So we assume. But 100 years, 80 years, 75, whatever the number, you have one chance to get it right.
That's it.
There's not enough time to just go day to day.
And you know what? You have more than one chance to get it right. Mm. Because you have all that time. It's just what you do with that time.
Right.
Right? Like, I make mistakes daily. Mm-hmm. I purposely sometimes and unintentionally. But every day that I wake up, I'm thankful and I say thank you because I have a chance to review that mistake and correct it. Right. Right. You can be 70 years old and still discover your purpose at 70 years old, mm-hmm. if you want to, you know, like, you're right. We have this one time on the merry-go-round that we're aware of, because the going into a spiritual conversation about different lives is right. like, we're not there right now, but we're only aware of where we are right in this moment.
Of course.
Right. So that's the consciousness we have to kind of embrace and honestly, like, just, for me, my goal is to help people clear that clutter. Mm-hmm. We have to clear the clutter. You may find things out about yourself. When I speak with people, I think people are scared to find out things about themselves.
Absolutely.
They're terrified because now that it explains me, now what? Where did this come from?
There's no excuses for it
anymore. Now you have to do something about it, right? Right. Maya Angelou, if you know, when you know better, do better.
Right.
Oprah used to use that all the time. When you know better, do better. Mm-hmm. But a lot of us want to stay in our ignorance.
Right.
Because then we continue. Absolutely. You continue with your nonsense.
Right.
and keep going with it, right? And the only person that'll check you on it is yourself, but you're not going to.
Right.
Right. So
there are so many questions on this right now. Philosophy and psychology are my favorite topics to discuss. There's one more question I have.
Okay.
You mentioned an inner standing, mm-hmm. and really realizing at the point when you might start to be going crazy.
Oh.
How do you recognize that?
Wow, phone call came in.
Right. It's okay, now. No worries.
I have to take the phone call.
I don't
guys.
Mind. We'll One pause second. It. Okay, so we're back. Got cut off by the phone call.
We here. Did. I ordered a soup.
Right. Well, we're talking about inner standing and really realizing that point when you might start to be going crazy. So what do you look for? How do you know?
Depending on what your crazy is.
Okay. It is different for everyone.
It is different for everybody. Mm-hmm. I'll speak about mine personally.
Okay.
So schizophrenia does run in my family. Mm-hmm. What people may not know is that I myself have a little bit. So there's times when I have those little bit of schizophrenic moments, yeah. because it's there.
So tell us, what is schizophrenia?
So schizophrenia there's different levels to schizophrenia. So there's different types of schizophrenia, mm-hmm. but it's basically a person who suffers from hallucinations and delusions.
Okay.
Right. That's the main premise of it. It's seeing what's not there, hearing what's not there. Right.
Interesting. Is that the same as multiple personalities?
Completely different. So multiple personalities is when many different personalities exist in one person.
Right.
So you'll have people who truly believe that other people are living inside of them. Mm. So Interesting you say that, because the Simone and Jenny, we'll get there in a second.
That's a nice question. Yeah.
So we'll get there in a second. Right. But with schizophrenia, my grandmother, she used to see insects crawling on her body when we're not there.
Oh, wow.
I knew that something was really wrong. And I'll never forget the day that my grandma called me and my brother to come look for a bird in the house. Okay. And the reason that it struck us was because I believed her. Because of how our chimney was, sometimes birds would get caught because they'd build their nest at the very top. And sometimes a bird will fall down.
So like, you had experienced it before.
Right. Mm. The birds had been there. But when she started to describe the bird to us, me and my brother were like, we should call mom or dad because this doesn't sound right.
Yeah.
She described this big white bird. And I'm just like, grandma, there's no big white bird in the house. It's impossible for the bird that you're... Besides, she was talking like a swan.
Right.
There's no way a swan fell through the chimney.
But in her mind, it was
but
real.
But she saw that. And wow. She made us look for it. And we had to call my mom, and I think she'd contacted my dad. I was young, so some of that stuff I did block, because it was a little tragic for us to see that.
Fair enough.
But for myself, when I'm feeling high levels of stress, there'll be times that I do. Like, I have to catch myself. Because one thing she used to do a lot of is, like, right? Because she'd feel them on her.
Right.
And I went through a really bad period about 7 years ago, and my mom caught me doing that. And she instantly got worried. Mm. But I was like, mom, don't worry. I know you noticed, but I knew already what was happening to me. I was like, mom, I have to tell myself that there's nothing on me. But this is the wonderful thing about understanding is like, I can tell myself that. That inner standing.
Of course.
Helps me know that Simone, you must be dealing with a level of stress now that you're ignoring. You better start paying attention to it.
So it's a way to help you to be more aware of your health as well.
Absolutely. Pay attention to your mind right now, because you are starting to do these things. You're starting to feel things that are not there. And that's where the inner standing comes in. If a lot of us understood what was happening, we could then at that point look at areas in our lives that are affecting us, whether it be financial, whether it be a relationship.
I was thinking the same thing.
Whether it be friendships, whether it be money, your job, relatives, there's something happening to you while you're feeling what you're feeling. Mm-hmm. And once you can identify that, again, you can start working on that. And of course, once I start doing that, the symptoms go away.
Yeah, so that's interesting.
Yeah, it's not something I recommend for everybody. Mm-hmm. Again, I have a lot more experience with it, so I've been handling this for such a long time that I'm able to. But it took me having to go see a therapist. It took me having to talk to social workers and see a psychologist. I had to go through that to get even a firmer understanding about who I was, right? So this is why I always recommend for anyone. You need to find somebody to talk to. It's very important.
Right.
Very important.
I'm glad you mentioned it. It's the first time I've heard the phrase understanding. And I think based on my own experience in the sales field, I've had experiences or talking to other realtors, for example, who say, when I get stressed, I don't know what to do in the business. And I think that's so common. Some people need that next paycheck to come in, but they stop working because they're scared, or they look for that full-time job and it takes away from their business. And the understanding of recognizing what situation you're in at that time.
Absolutely.
And stopping yourself from falling
into
prey
that.
To it.
Yes. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people can't do that.
It sounds like it's a difficult thing to do.
It's very difficult to do. Like, again, I say it all the time. There's a lot of us, we're walking zombies.
Right.
That's what it is. Think about Nas. Nas had a song out called Black Zombies. Yeah. That's what we are. We're walking zombies. We're just existing, not living.
Right.
So, Jenny, so you're asking about Jenny.
Yeah, that was the next one.
So, okay. So many things to me. So,
right.
I suffer from addictions. Okay. As well. See, again, things that people don't really... I know about myself. This is why I'm able to sometimes control myself.
I admire
But I suffer from certain addictions. I won't go into those right now.
Okay.
But those come out with Jenny. She's the person who, when that side is out, it's her.
Okay.
Simone's the more polished, the person you see sitting here now.
Right, very professional.
Right? Very professional. Yeah. Jenny is more these.
Okay. And there are stories behind those, I see.
Every single one of them, right? She's the one who brings those out. When that side of me is active, she's the one who gets into trouble.
Really? To this day?
To this day.
Okay.
She gets into trouble. But again, it's understanding who you are and truly embracing it and not, because we all have sides to us.
Right.
It's not something that's not even a mental health thing. That's just who we are.
Of course.
The balance, the yin and yang, the dark and the light, there's there's that in all of us, but a lot of us don't identify our demons. We dance with our demons, but pretend they're not there. And that's why sometimes we hear all these stories to come out, things like with Tiger Woods, where all of a sudden he has like 1,000 women who he's been sleeping with. And it's like, I've always said, I will be very open to tell people my demons, because you can't use my demons against me. I know them already, and I'll tell you about them.
Right.
So you can't be like, oh my God, did you hear about Simone? I'm like, oh my God,
no,
I told you this like 10 years ago. Go watch one of my shows.
Of course.
So it's being strong enough to identify that demon that you have, because we all have them. And again, control and balance and understanding and knowing when that side of you comes up, right? And knowing how to, because sometimes you need to live dangerously and have fun. That's part of life.
Within reason.
But not all the time.
Right.
Right. Simone's the reason.
Right. So did you develop that second personality intentionally? Or did you just say...
Phantom limb.
Okay.
Phantom limb. And I'll explain that.
Yeah.
So the phantom limb that I called Jenny obviously came about through trauma. And it allowed me to separate myself from me. Right. So I could separate all the bad things I did and put it over there.
Right.
And then go back to my normal life and pretend that it didn't happen. But it exists and existed. And it was from my pain. The pain brought her out. I've talked to some of the other women in my life who have experienced some of the trauma I have.
Right.
And they speak on the same, that same idea of having, I didn't know what they called it, but it's called the phantom limb. It's just that part of you that's a phantom. It's a ghost, but it's there.
Yeah.
You know, and we... You can ignore it for so long before sometimes it can completely ruin your life. Innerstanding. It's so important to have that.
It sounds
that.
Like it.
Very, very important.
So would you recommend a personality like that for someone going through any trauma, or is it a very specific situation?
Depending on your trauma.
It
all depends on your trauma. Most addicts have gone through something because they have to turn to something to deal with it, the anxiety that comes with that trauma,
right?
So they'll turn, you have the common things, alcohol, obviously drugs, name them, pills. But there's some addictions that people don't understand that they have, like shopping is an addiction, right? People don't get it. Binge watching television is an addiction. You may not think it is.
Hours go by, you don't realize.
You don't even realize it, and you're like, oh my gosh, I've lost all of this time, right? Technology is an addiction.
I've been there.
Right?
I'm sure we all have at some point.
Take a phone away from someone. Leave your phone at home.
Right.
You look like a crackhead. You're like, oh my God, where's my phone?
You'll drive back an hour to get it.
What? Like, have you seen someone without their phone? Take an iPad away from a child.
Right.
And watch that child crumble.
It's the craziest thing. Technologies that we didn't have, 15, 20 years ago are necessary.
Controlling our lives.
Right.
And they're not. And see, it's funny. You just said they're necessary. No, they're not.
Right.
They're not necessary. Right? Like, we've made them necessary. And this is where that, again, that whole addiction, people think it's just like drugs and stuff like that. No. Anything that you turn to instead of dealing with whatever trauma you're dealing with can become an addiction.
I see.
So
it's always there to make you feel better at that
absolutely.
Time.
Absolutely. That little like that you get on Facebook, dopamine hit, addiction.
Yeah.
You know, oh my God, someone paid attention to me. Oh my God, someone likes my picture. Oh my God.
Put more.
Addiction. Because we go on to get that dopamine hit. That, oh my God. Like, there's been studies done on this.
Mm-hmm.
Like, one of the previous members of Facebook spoke on this.
I think I saw that one.
Yes.
Yeah.
That. If Facebook has become a drug,
right?
Social media is a drug. We check how many followers do I have today? How many? These are all addictions.
And the infinite scroll, just looking for something.
Looking for something. What are you looking for? Pick up a book. I get so irritated. I'm like, I learned a rule.
Mm-hmm.
The first 20 minutes of your day and the last 20 minutes of your day must be sacred to you and your space and your understanding.
Mm.
I know people who the very first thing they do is pick up that phone first thing in the morning.
Right.
And think about that. You're letting everybody else's garbage
dictate
your day, right?
Mm-hmm.
No, you must control your space. After an hour or so, if you want to check to see what's happening, obviously we all do it. I still do it too. Mm. But that first 20 minutes, that last 20 minutes of my day, I'm sorry, I'm not giving it to the world to dictate how I feel.
Right.
Because it does. It dictates how you feel.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So
what do you
my touch on social media.
No, that's perfect. What do you put into your sacred time in the first 20 minutes or the last 20 minutes?
It depends. Sometimes it's just quiet. It's just, I'll sit there and let my mind kind of swirl. Sometimes it's prayer.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's meditation. Sometimes it might be something that I want to read. Sometimes it's a review of what I've learned the day before. So I do a lot of writing. I write things. I have so many notebooks in my bag. Like, mm-hmm. So that might just be me taking a notebook out and kind of just reviewing what I've learned. What did I learn yesterday that I can share?
Right.
Because I have an understanding that knowledge isn't mine. It's to share.
Of course.
I'm just a messenger, right? And I have to find a way to deliver that message so that people can understand it and that it's not scary for them and that they don't get in their feelings. I take that time to do all of that processing.
Mm-hmm.
And then I do my workout and start my day.
Tell us about your show here, Here to Help You.
So Here to Help You was based off my show Here to, oh, not my show, my company,
mm-hmm.
Here to Help.
Okay.
So Here to Help is a community development company. And with that, it means that we work very much in the community to help them develop. My focuses are mental health, mm-hmm. education. Those are my top two focuses. Right now, we are working in the Jane and Finch, the Driftwood area, Dixon, Rexdale.
Mm-hmm.
So the areas that are considered high risk. And we work very closely with the families. We go into their homes and we work with the children on numerous things. So it could be scholarship writing, English learning. A lot of our families are not from here. They're from other parts of the world. So we'll help them with just getting like centered and getting kind of used to Canada. Oh my goodness, obviously mental health counseling, mental health work as well. And the show is focused on that. It's focused on us as people and what we've gone through, and not just the negative, not the slavery narrative, no. It's the, what are we gonna do to take action now?
Right.
And the one way we can take action is by learning.
Right.
Education is key to everything in life.
And we're talking about that before we started recording too.
Education.
Of course.
You need that. It's so important. So Here to Help You, we educate our people. And you know what? People are sometimes like, oh my gosh, you know, you don't get the views, you're not getting high views. And I'm like, because the information we're giving is not for the small-minded. And I don't mean that in any negative way.
Yeah.
I'm saying in the sense that, again, we're dealing with people who are in survival mode.
Mm.
How can you really think and process these concrete ideas when you're surviving?
All right? You can think about is the next day.
That's it, right?
Or today.
Or even today.
Mm.
So it doesn't make me not want to do it, because I know that the work that we're doing now, myself and Dave, my partner, it's going to be noticed 10 years from now,
mm-hmm.
15 years from now. I'm thinking legacy. I'm not worried about views now.
Right.
I'm thinking about how and who this is going to affect 20 years from now. I'm looking at how my children will feel when they see mom has done this something. 20 years ago, mom, you were doing this. Absolutely, I was.
Right.
You know, like... So that's what our effort, that's where our efforts are, is to really develop our community, because we need it.
Mm.
And I've always been told by a lot of my elders that, Simone, you're out here and, you know, you're learning all this education, all this European education, and you're going through this European system. But if you're doing that and not using it to help better your people, you're wasting your time.
Right.
Right. So that's what I do. Everything I learn, whether my people want to hear it or not, I'm still going to give it to them.
Of course.
Hoping that someone, I just want that.
The one person to run with it.
That light, that, you know, that's all I'm looking for. I don't care. I will continue to do it. And that's the thing about me, is I'm relentless.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care if I get one like on something. I'm still going to share it, because that one person who liked it, it triggered them. That's all I need. I don't need 1,000 likes on something.
Right.
I want to impact one person.
If I can
impact one person each day,
mm.
That's all that matters.
That's fantastic. So what is your goal 5 years, 10 years down the line?
Actually, I plan to, again, I'm thinking huge. I want to be, I want to take this internationally.
Okay.
I want to be able to take Here to Help to different parts of the diaspora and to help communities grow. Like, I want to go in there and do the same thing that I've done in Toronto, right? Again, it's about your little footprint.
Right.
You know, your little mark that you leave.
Right.
So that's what I wanted. 5 to 10 years, I see us global. That's what I see.
Yeah.
That's where I'm thinking. I'm thinking global.
Like that.
Toronto will always be our home because, honestly, Toronto's branded. Toronto's a brand name. Like, I tell people all the time, like, I may not necessarily, I don't love Toronto. Mm-hmm. I'm going to be honest. Even though I'm from Toronto, I don't love Toronto.
No hard feelings.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, like, yeah. It's okay.
Right.
But it's branded.
Right.
Doesn't matter where you go in this world. You say Toronto, people know Toronto. Right. So I'm going to utilize that.
Of course.
To
of course.
The best of my ability, right?
Might as well.
So, that's my plan.
Yeah. Do you have any mentors or role models that you kind of follow in the
first place? Absolutely. Absolutely. I have, I'm going to say the universe has put people in my life. I have a really great mentor. His name is Michael E. Williams. He's a man that a lot of people, I wish they knew more about him. So if you, any of the comedians that you know, at this point right now, they've all gone through his hands.
Okay.
He opened up one of the first comedy spots for African people to deliver in America. He was the person who did it.
Okay.
So I get to speak to him on a regular basis.
Are you serious?
He lives, absolutely, and he lives in Las Vegas now.
Yeah.
So he's one of my like go-tos every time.
Right.
Mr. Errol Gibbs is one of my newer ones. So this man, another phenomenal, oh my goodness, like talking to him, he's actually studying a column still called Philosophically Speaking in the Toronto Caribbean newspaper. And
okay.
He's another mastermind. I mean, these people are like
thinkers.
Way above me, mind you. It's very important to mind who you're around. If you are the smartest person in the room, there is a problem.
I heard that before.
You should never
right.
be the smartest person in the room. So there's that. I'll deal with that after. So the reason I'm laughing is because Grant is here. He's the owner of the Toronto Caribbean newspaper, and he's carrying on with the most right now. What else? Who else do I have in my corner? Some local as well. Clifton Joseph.
Okay.
Huge name in the Caribbean community. Mm-hmm. He's another person who I can turn to and say, I have a question for you. And if you notice, I'm naming off a lot of men.
Right.
That just seems to be how my life has turned. Where it's mostly men who
right.
are in my life and give me that guidance. And I have, obviously, my mom and my dad.
Of course.
And they are the center of everything that I am.
Mm-hmm.
Everything. They have showed me what it means and what it takes to be a leader and what it means, what it takes to be a woman, regardless of what you do, what you've done, the mistakes you've made, you still hold your head high and make sure you do what you're supposed to do.
Period. Responsibilities first and
be
always.
Responsible. Right. Always. I'm at work, guys. This is why this phone is ringing.
One more
we
phone
can't,
call.
I don't think I have to take this one.
Okay.
No, I don't. I don't got to take this one.
No worries.
But yeah, those are the, I aim to have elders in my life. You need elders. All of us need elders. Mm. It's very important that we have elders in our life because they've been here already. They've done it already. They know a lot more than we do.
Yeah.
Right? And you can just sit down and learn. Oh, I do have to mention two more people. Dr. Paul and Lillian Wong. These are two psychologists. They are the leading meaning-centered psychologists in Canada.
Okay.
I worked with them for 9 years and I learned everything that I've learned when it comes to living a meaningful life and helping people live a meaningful life has come from them.
Okay.
So again, elders, they're in their 70s.
Right.
So these, I'm talking about, all these people I've named are over 60 years old.
Human nature doesn't change no matter how technology changes along the way.
Human nature, people will stay the same. So
right.
these have been my major influencers and I think it's why I really am I'm different. Mm-hmm. I'm not like a lot of people.
Right.
But I'm okay with that.
Of course.
I'm okay with that.
We're all a little bit different, a little bit, right?
Yeah. I guess so. In our own little ways.
Of course. Final question for you. If you could have any superpower in the world, what would it be?
So I don't know if anyone watches Marvel. Are you a comic book?
Huge Marvel fan.
All right.
Of course.
Purple Man.
I don't know Purple Man.
What? Okay. Okay. Have you heard of Jessica Jones?
Of course, yeah.
Purple Man is the man who can control your mind.
Okay.
He's the one who will say, get up, walk out this door, jump out the window, and you will not be able to control yourself.
He wasn't in the Luke Cage series,
was he? No, he was in the very first Jessica Jones series.
Okay.
Purple Man is legendary. He controls the mind.
Right.
He can make you do whatever he wants. If I could have any power in the world, which... Actually, I'm going to keep that. That's my secret.
Right.
Because, you know, I don't want to tell people that.
We're going to come back for that secret. Interesting. I've never heard that one before.
But this Purple Man, he can control people's minds. That's my power. Because
what would you do with that?
Wow. You know what? I would really want my people to just do better. Mm-hmm. Wouldn't it be nice if you could say to someone, get your life together by doing this, 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 and they just do it?
They had to do it.
They couldn't, even if they were trying not to do it, they'd still do it.
You can't help but doing right. Interesting.
Be a better person by doing this, this, and this. And even if they want to do bad, they can't do bad. Imagine right. having that power. How wonderful that would be.
That's the first I've heard that. That's unique.
Yeah, man. To control people's minds.
Simone, how can we get a hold of you if you want more information about the series?
Oh my gosh, you can look for Simone Jennifer Smith at Simone Jennifer Smith anywhere. Google me. I am everywhere and anywhere doing a lot of work. And definitely, like, even if you have questions about mental health, reach out. Like, if I don't know something, believe me, I will research it or find the person who can answer your question. I don't claim to know everything, but I will do the research for you.
We appreciate that.
Absolutely.
Of course. And do you have any final advice? Any last words for the viewers?
Live a good life. Live your best life. Live your best life. That's a song. Living your best life. Do it.
Are you a singer too?
No.
Okay.
Sounded good though, didn't it?
That was nice.
I know. That's my dad. That's nothing to do with me. That's my dad. But live your best life, everybody. Do your best.
You like that. Thank you very much, Simone.
Of course.
Appreciate your time.
Thank you. Have a great day, guys.
And that's it.